And welcome to Net Forum. The topic of today's lecture is binding and binding time. Before that, in the last lecture, we have discussed the concept of syntax and syntactic analyzer. In fact, syntax and semantic analyzer. And what is the difference between syntax and semantics? We have discussed that. And now, in this particular lecture, we are going to discuss the concept of binding and binding time. Right? So, what is the definition of binding? So, the definition of binding is binding is an association of element and its property, which we can also say data type in particular. When we write, for example, you can give example also, integer A equal to say 10. Then here A is binded with this integer, and this particular binding, this particular concept is known as binding. Right? This 10 is associated or is stored in A. So type of binding is there also, but here we are talking about the binding with the data types. And the binding of in terms of the property of the variable, we are not talking about the storage. So here this particular concept is known as binding, the association of variable with the data type. This is the exact definition of binding. Now the question comes, what is the binding time? Binding time basically means binding time basically means the phase in which binding took place. That means when binding took place, what is the phase? So when we talk about phase, that means there would be at least there would be two phases. So first phase is execution phase and second one is translation phase. They have two very common names also: compile time and run time. Now compile time and run time, sorry, run time and compile time. So runtime association is entirely different in comparison to the compile time association. So first of all, and one more name is there also, the question comes in any name. This is known as the early late binding, this is known as early binding, or this is known as static binding. Dynamic binding. This is known as static binding. So in this way, there are multiple names of this particular property. And we are going to see this, how this whole construct work. So please note it out that question can come in any way. It can come, what is the difference between execution phase and translation phase? Question can come in, what is the difference between runtime and compile time, like late binding or early binding, static binding or dynamic binding. So question can come in any way. We are going to discuss each and every point in detail. The first one is known as the execution phase. We have the concept of execution time. In execution time, we have, suppose there is a variable V. In this particular variable V, this particular variable V will have binding with two different type of things. The first one is type, and second one is it has binding with the storage, right? What is the meaning of this particular thing? Let us say integer A equal to 10 and integer pointer P. When I write P equal to A, right, this is known as a storage binding. This is known as type binding. Remember this particular point. Now, let us see the concept of swapping, where we use pointers, and that is a real example of the concept of execution time or late binding. And whenever question comes, you please make the program of swap. We all have made that program of swap also, where we pass the addresses and we come take them in the pointer variables, and then we do the swapping, and or we can do the addition, whatever we want. So that particular binding of the actual parameter and former parameter is the late binding, and it is binding on demand when the program execute. It has not been done in the compilation, it has not been done in earlier, but when the program flows and then that particular function get called, then that binding take place. Now let's take an example, very quick example, integer main, integer A equal to say 10, B equal to say 20, and we call sum address of A comma address of B. Here we have written integer sum pointer P comma pointer Q, integer pointer K equal to pointer B plus pointer Q, print or return pointer K, whatever we want. If there is any type of syntactical error, please avoid that, because the main thing is the concept. So this particular binding must take place, this particular binding you please show them with the help of the black pen and all other markers which you are allowed to use. This particular binding is known as late binding or binding at execution time. The binding between the actual parameters and formal parameters will take place at runtime. This is the runtime binding, because this binding is being done, this is a function call, and this binding will be done, this all bindings will be done. But this association between the actual parameter and former parameter will take place only when the program will run, right? So this particular binding which is being done at runtime is known as the execution time binding. Otherwise, all these bindings, this binding are at translation time or at compile time. So this is the very basic difference between the compile time binding and translation time binding. Please make it sure. So why this particular question is being asked in each and every exam, in each and every term, whenever this subject comes, this is a very important question which is being normally being asked. right? So I hope you know get an idea of the static binding or dynamic binding, whatever it comes. It comes early binding, late binding, execution, or whatever it comes. You make the diagram, you make this program or any program which shows the function calling, right? And then the binding between the actual parameter and former parameter is being done at the runtime. This is a very good example to show this particular construct. So I hope you like this lecture. If you like this lecture, then please subscribe my channel and be with me for the entire process of the principle of programming languages. Happy learning. Thank you very much.